Feedback. You know, life's full of feedback. We always need feedback on everything we engage in life. Online learning is no different. In fact, we may need more feedback in online environments than in any environment that we're in, because we're alone. There needs to be a sense that there's an instructor or someone in the class that cares about my learning, that lets me know how I'm doing, or I'm going to be off task, potentially flounder within that online setting. So feedback becomes critical. This is Providing Feedback, a section on this from Indiana University. Of course, you need to know the importance of feedback. Why are we doing feedback? Well, if you don't have good feedback built in an online class, everything else is going to flounder. You won't have much success within that online class. Building feedback is critical. Second, you need to have constructive forms of feedback. Don't just have pip, wrong answers, or right answers built within a class. You need to have many forms of constructive feedback built within a classroom setting. Have specific things that you're saying, and these things can be coming from an individual, it could be coming from a group, it could be coming from themselves, from the system, it could be coming from peers, it could come from experts. There are many ways in which to get feedback for students within a classroom setting, or give feedback within an online classroom setting. The timing and amounts of feedback are critical. When are you going to give feedback? How much feedback are you going to give? What specific activities are going to get the most feedback and require most of your time? Is it going to be an online task or assignments or group work? Is it going to be in the discussion forum? Is it going to be somewhere else? So where are you going to give the feedback, and when in your schedule are you going to give feedback? Timing of that. And what efficiencies might you build in so that there are specific days in which you build into the system to give feedback? There are problems, of course, in giving feedback, because sometimes students want feedback on everything they do. If you try and give feedback on everything they do, you will die. And if you don't provide feedback on anything, however, the course will flounder. So there's some happy medium in between. And there are also tricks and tips I can give you for giving proper amounts of feedback so that your course will succeed. Be the first one to post. Be the last one to post. Post controversial topic headings that will get people engaged. But feedback so that students know when you're going to be coming in. Give them a sense of timing. Read up on it. Read things from the Illinois Online Network. Read things from Johns Hopkins University Medical School and watch their dean give a lecture on providing feedback. Read tech tips for educators from the University of Wisconsin or Penn State or other places around the world. But don't be Superman. Don't be Superwoman and give feedback on everything, or you will not succeed. You will be frustrated. You will have health problems if you try and give feedback because, hey, in a face-to-face class, students don't expect feedback on everything. Why are you expecting to do that online? Build in peer feedback. Build in self-feedback. Build in system feedback. Build in expert feedback as well as your feedback. And if it's international in nature, there's even more difficulties because of timing. If it's cross-cultural, cross-collaborate, cross-institutional, where you have more institutions than just your own place or more organizations. If it's global, there's more people involved to potentially use as peers for that feedback. But don't give feedback on every post. If you, you're going to run a risk of overextending yourself, right? And you won't have time for other things in your life or in that class. So put time in your planner. Say, I'm going to give feedback on Friday afternoons. And those are the times you go in and you don't schedule other meetings there, or Saturday mornings or Monday mornings, or when you're going to go in your online or physical planner. Allocate that time so that you don't go in every day and students don't expect you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, because the sun never sets on the online class. And use summative feedback twice a week so students know how they're doing. Include their names. And if you include their names in the feedback, they'll start including each other's names and they'll get to know each other. And there's this social connectedness that builds. You know, you can also include group names where possible. Embed peer feedback. Require not only your feedback, but peer feedback. Maybe assign critical friends or web buddies and have the most confident person help the least confident person as critical friend activities or email pals so they know that someone every week is going to give them feedback. Maybe it's the instructor, but for sure the critical friend will. Post a job aid for reflection and feedback so that students know how to interact with one another, when to interact, and the timing of it. If you've got a job aid and some advice and some examples from previous semesters of feedback, they'll know how to give each other feedback. And if you've got things you've used previous semesters, you can cut and paste it in terms of feedback, especially those things that are long and very specific in nature that you can potentially reuse. Send an email feedback to your students once a week or an announcement so that students, again, can get a sense that the instructor is there that cares. He's going to close off the discussion, start the discussion, and so forth. Bring in experts and practitioners into the class for feedback when you can. Respond to students within 24 hours. You know, if you can respond, if you can bring in experts, if you get peer feedback, you'll have success. Use fax. Use email. Use chat. Use a phone if you have to call them. Use the discussion forums. Use a synchronous conference. There are many ways to get students the feedback that they need. Again, it's the feedbacks that you build within the system that will enable all systems to be a go. You have to find a way to get your students some respect, some sense that there is some notion that someone cares about them, that their discussions, their tasks, their assignments, their webcasts all have some form of advice, guidelines, feedback built in. If you have enough feedback built into the system, students will strive to succeed. They'll push towards new goals. They'll be satisfied with the class, and maybe will take additional classes as a result of that pointed feedback that you've provided to them. I think feedback is the one aspect that keeps the whole system running. And if you do a good job there, you'll have many chances for success. Wish you well in providing feedback.